Ladies and gentlemen, the problem is when you want to get married in our country, for example, Indonesia, well, you have to get two approvals. First, from our law, and second, from our religious department, ladies and gentlemen. And since when you don't have any kind of approval from our law, which has to ask the consent and the permission from our religious department, we don't think that you will have your rights, you will have the permission to get married in our culture and in our law values, ladies and gentlemen, in Indonesia, vice versa. And we don't think that we need to make new regulations from this kind of, from this kind of problems, since our religious department sees that it is too hard and too risky to afford them. To accommodate and to make it affordable for this kind of things could be happening in St. Charles. And we say from our point of view that the nature of marriage in St. Charles, you want to bond two different big families. We don't just simply say that you bond two different people from two different ethnicity and values and religions and etc. things, ladies and gentlemen. But we want to born two different big families, ladies and gentlemen. And we are facing problems when sometimes even one big family will not accept any kind of different ethnicities, even more, any kind of different religions, ladies and gentlemen. Because sometimes we don't really accept, or we don't really, you know, accept pluralism as the nature it is, ladies and gentlemen. The member of his house. Well, we could just give you the example of the, Toraja and the Buginese ethnicity in our cities, in our citizens, ladies and gentlemen. Well, what we can see from this kind of ethnics, we see that sometimes this kind of ethnics is very hard to accept any kind of different religion when their members of their family want to get married from the other religion, ladies and gentlemen. Because the nature of this kind of ethnicity, they really expect and they really uphold their own, values, especially the religions. They see that this kind of values is very sensitive value, ladies and gentlemen. So we don't think that you have to, accommodate the minority aspiration that needs to make the new regulation, while the majority voice is not accommodated, ladies and gentlemen. Before I'm going further, yes.
But that problem is not happened to every type of interfaith marriage, sir. So if they are facing that kind of problem, then they can simply not get married.
We cannot have it in all kind of values, ladies and gentlemen. But since we see that this is a problem inside, that sometimes you are facing the problems when some ethnicity, it is very hard for them to accept different religion to come into their families. We see that we don't have to make any kind of new regulation to make it affordable, ladies and gentlemen, and to input different religions member of the other family into another family of this kind of ethnicity. We don't think that it is so necessary to make any new regulations. And we probably say, ladies and gentlemen, that the government has to respect and accommodate this kind of aspiration from this kind of ethnicity and their values. They are upholding. They are
upholding.
No, sir. And we see, ladies and gentlemen, on giving our response to the issue of minority and the majority, we don't think that we need to accommodate the minority voices while we ignore and we abandon the voice of the majority. Because we see, ladies and gentlemen, that the implications could be so much dangerous. Could be, it could pretty much endanger the society. Because it could create, demonstration. It could create chaos among the citizens. Because the government failed to accommodate the majority voices of the citizens. And we don't think that we have to accommodate the minority voices while the majority is left behind. Well, this is not an issue of democratic at all. Because when we are talking about democracy, we can consider, we consider lots of things, including the voices of the majority of the citizens, ladies and gentlemen. And therefore, we probably say again that we don't think we need to accommodate and make new regulation on that kind of system. And ladies and gentlemen, we say also, the issue of the government in practice consistency. When they say that the government has made the regulation that legalizing the death penalty and the alcohol in our law, well, we say that we got to point in here. Before I'm going further, yes.
So the minority also as a part of this country. So where is the democracy in this country actually?
Well, no, ladies and gentlemen, we say that yes, we have to respect the minority voices, but we have to consider lots of things. And we don't think, ladies and gentlemen, since the majority voices are left abandoned, we don't think that the majority would not react on this kind of new regulation, ladies and gentlemen. We see that there is an abundance of powers that, you know, that oppose this kind of system. We see that it could create a chaos, ladies and gentlemen. It could create a demonstration. We see that we don't think that we need to create another new regulation. No, sir. No, ma'am. And
sir,
explaining my so-called arguments that yet to be explained. Well, we say that when they say that the government has made the legalization on death penalty and the alcohol, we say that the fact is, yes, the government has disobeyed the values of two different religions. First, that we legalize the death penalty, that we break the the values of the Christ, and we also break the values of the Muslims by legalizing the alcohol things in our citizens, in our country. And yes, the government has, you know, has given the reflection that the government is doing the, you know, some kind of disrespect of the values of the religions, of this kind of two religions. And since they say they want to make new regulation, we don't think that it would be you know, pretty much good of idea to, you know, the government of another making new regulation and another breaking the values of another religion also, ladies and gentlemen. Since we say that this would be pretty much worse the image of the government, since the government again break the values of the one religion, let's say Muslim religions. And ladies and gentlemen, we can also say that it would create further harm when we want to make the new regulation that we legalize the interfaith marriage. Yes, we see that the regulation of the alcohol that exists now in our country, this has broken one values in the Muslim society, ladies and gentlemen. And if we could take an example, the Muslim extremists, ladies and gentlemen, the Muslim extremists, they still do some, you know, some operation with this alcohol system, ladies and gentlemen. And therefore, we see, ladies and gentlemen, that when we want to break another values of religion, what we are afraid and what we are preventing is that this kind of could be more doing some operations also to this kind of system. And with all these reasons, we probably oppose.